Hi guys, welcome back to the channel. So it's your girl Justine, and I know it has been a long time that you guys haven't seen me on camera, but I'm back and better. Okay, I'm getting better. So yeah, so as you guys can tell by the title, this is a video about me getting scammed technically. So yeah, but first, before we start, don't forget to hit that subscribe button down below, give it a thumbs up, and also don't forget to share this video around so people can be aware of, you know, Facebook, you know, this Facebook selling app and Cash App, because I was scammed through, you know, I was explaining to you guys, but technically the person used both of those apps to scam me. So yeah, before we get started, make sure you guys also follow me on my social platform. That's Instagram, Twitter, and Snapchat. They'll be listed in the description box down below for your convenience. And yeah, let's get started. Okay, boom. So as you guys can tell, I haven't been able to upload like I normally do, like I wanted to this summer, because first, you guys already know I got my car. In the last video I mentioned I got my car. I bought my first car the same day I bought my first car, got into a car accident. And today is June 14th, so it's been 3 weeks now that I have been out of cars. I bought my car 3 weeks ago, and I'm out of cars since, and I'm supposed to go into the mechanic to, you know, get my car today, hopefully. But yeah, you know, it's beside the point, but I'm telling you guys, like, a lot of things have been happening to me. Car accident yesterday, again I got into another second car accident with, you know, with another car, and someone hit me, and that happened 2 days ago. I cut myself on my leg real bad, and you know, a lot of things have been happening. So I'm really sorry if I'm not uploading some videos. I'll do my best to come back on track, but you guys know, you know, I was really trying to do my best to upload more this summer, but life just got in the way. Okay, but yeah, let's just get right into this video. So technically, you guys know I was looking for a MacBook Pro for to edit my videos, but I mean, I already got one. Let me show you guys. It looks so cute, the cover. That's my MacBook Pro. If you follow me on Snapchat, then you've seen it already. But yeah, I was looking for that so I can, you know, better my editing quality as far as here on YouTube. And yeah, I was looking for one, and I went on eBay, Amazon, and I was like, snap, let me go on Facebook to shop. So I went on Facebook, you know, I found one that was $800, but the person lived in New York, and that person is a YouTuber, by the way. So if you want me to expose the YouTuber, he's the one that scammed me. It's a YouTuber that scammed me through his Facebook page, and then he's trying to say his account was hacked, but I'm sure it's him, because several people have been complaining about him hacking them, you know, prior to me. But yeah, I'll get to that later. I might expose, you know, I might post a video saying exposing this YouTuber. Is a male YouTuber, by the way, and he's known here on YouTube. So I was like, oh snap, you know, I did my research, he's a YouTuber. So I'm like, okay, I'm guessing it's one of his old computers that he's selling, you know, and all this stuff. So I'm like, okay, good, at least, you know, he's a YouTuber. So I was asking him about, you know, what app do you still have on it. He was like, yeah, I still have the movie Final Cut Pro that I bought, you know, for my editing and for my music, because he also does music and all this stuff. So, you know, you are covered on that part. Like, he was really like reassuring me and making me feel like, you know, you're getting a real great deal for $800. You're getting it was like a 2015 or 14 MacBook Pro. And like, he was telling me, you know, it's a really good deal. I only used it, you know, a couple of times. So I was happy, you know. I was like, oh yeah, it's another YouTuber, so like, of course he knows what I need. And then he was like, okay, we started talking about price. I said, I'm not saying I don't trust you. I actually didn't trust him, for real. But I was like, I'm not saying I don't trust you, but I feel like I cannot just send you the full $800 unless I get like the tracking number or something showing that you're sending the things my way. So he agreed. He said, okay, cool. He said, at least put half, so I'm sure that you pay me the rest. He was like, oh, don't think I'm about to scam you. Like, why are you scared for? That's what he's telling me. So mind you, I was just like, okay, how can I send you the money? PayPal. He was like, his PayPal account got blocked because of so many transactions, some stuff like that. And I was like, okay. So he was like, do I have Google Wallet? I said, no. And then that's when Cash App came up. He was like, all this conversation was going on our, you know, Facebook Messenger thing. So after I saw the MacBook, you know, I went ahead and I just messaged him and asked him how, if it's available and all the specs about the MacBook. And I just said, okay, Cash App, cool. In my head, I'm like, okay, Cash App, even though it's not so safe, But, you know, if I put a complaint, it's his name that he used. And he's going to transfer to a bank account. I don't know what bank account, but a bank account, which would make me be able to catch him that way if he, you know, scare me. So, as he was at $400. So, I sent him $400. Right? I kid you not. Like, as he was like, at first I was like, can I take a picture of you? Because, you know, I was making sure he's a real person, you know. He's the person I'm talking to. He was like, I'm at the airport. So still send me a picture. This nigga was in the room. He held a suitcase on his leg. And he was like, he didn't show his face. He was like, with the hood on. And I was like, show your face. So I'll make sure it's you. And he showed half of his face, right? He sent me the picture. So I'm like, okay. That's the person. That's the person. That's the YouTuber, you know, I'm talking about. I'll make sure it was really him. So after sending the $400, this guy trying to tell me, oh, by the way, I'm white. And this wasn't really me. I just had this person's YouTube account. Okay, first of all, if you had the person, I just had the person's Facebook account. If you had the person's Facebook account, how do you still have the pictures that I asked you to send and then you're able to send me? That means, you know, it's you, one. And number two, he was like, you know, good luck with, because I was like, I'm about to file a police report and call the police on you, you know, they're about to catch you. Blah, blah. And then he was like, good luck doing that because I'm white, first of all. And second of all, I'm about to log off this account and all that. He said some stuff like that. So before he was like, he's about to block me and log off the account because he already got what he wanted. So before he went ahead and deleted me, I just clicked on his profile quick. And then that's when I went on his page. I looked like at his status, how he was saying, oh God, like a month or two before he scared me, he posted something like, hi guys, I'm sorry I've been absent on Facebook, but someone hacked my account and scammed a lot of people that have been complaining about me scamming them. Guys, it's not me, it's someone else that scammed you guys, you know, I'm so sorry about it. Like, started apologizing. So in my head I was like, that this doesn't even make any sense, because you cannot start apologizing. Because he did that, like, I saw two or three started saying that, like, and they had like gap in between them. So which means that I came to the conclusion that he technically like scammed his fans or people in general, and then he goes like ghost and then come back and be like, oh guys, I'm sorry, someone hacked my account. And then he goes, whenever he need the money again, he does the same thing over and over until like he stack a good amount of money. Because I was like, who gets hacked over and over and over like that? Especially like, it's not like his Instagram got hacked, then his Twitter, his that same Facebook account that keep getting hacked over and over. So I'm like, who gets hacked over and over and over like that and doesn't find a way to like secure their account well, you know? So that already brought something like in my head, like to think about. I'm like, bro, did you really get hacked or did you just scam me? Like, you have been scamming other people, like, what? So I contacted my bank. My bank told me, you know, they're gonna put the money in my account. And until, because I tried to go back and cash up, and I sent him the 400 request, you know, I requested it. If you have cash up, you understand. I requested it. He didn't answer until like cash up, you know, told me, you know, they canceled the transaction, like missed requesting money to him was canceled because he didn't respond. And then I was okay. So that's in there. I contacted my bank, and then my bank like put a $400 provisional fund in my account. So tell me why 2 days ago I get a letter in the mail telling me the $400 would be reversed back to the, you know, to the bank, because they realized that this transaction was a personal transaction. It's not like I had to deal with like eBay or deal with Amazon, you know. They were like, the fact that it was a one-on-one, like, you know, personal thing, I have to deal with Cash App or Facebook, find a way to contact them. So far I contacted Cash App and they said they're working on paying me, you know, the money back, but it's like a process, so they do an investigation right now. I sent them the screenshots and the name of the guy on Facebook and his name on Cash App and the date, the, you know, the whole thing happened. Like, they're working on it. But yeah, that's how I got scammed on the Facebook shopping app, or the, not even app, the section, you know, the shopping section on Facebook. Yeah, that's how I got scammed on Facebook and Cash App technically, because he used Cash App. And yeah, so that's the story I had for you guys today. You know, the lesson that you guys need to take from this story is, don't trust anybody online unless it's like an actual like true seller or a website, trusted website. Do not buy things on that Facebook stuff unless you're gonna like meet with a person and pay. That's normally what you do, you meet with them. But that's why when I told him, I was like, his status, like the reason why like he appeared on my area is because he said he was in my state. But at the end of the day, when I asked him, he was like, oh, I already left your state. I'm in New York now. So I'm like, that's not official. That's when I started not even trusting him. He was like, I'm in New York. I'm like, so you're in New York, and whole time computer say is, you know, the person that posted this state is in like the DMV area, you know, DC, Maryland, Virginia area. So he was like, oh no, I was just there for a concert, now I'm leaving. But like I said, guys, if you guys want me to expose this YouTuber, oops, my remote fell. If you guys want me to expose this YouTuber, I will, like, because I feel like he's the one that did it right now. Yeah, do under this investigation. But if you guys want me to expose this YouTuber, I'll post his YouTube channel, or that y'all can go ahead and, you know, maybe one of you guys was came by him or something. And yeah, thank you guys so much for watching this video, you know, and thank you guys so much for the support and the love. And yeah, I hope I'm back at it and I'm better, you know. So yeah, I know I haven't posted for a long time now, but you know, I'll do my best to post more, like I said. And yeah, that's it for today's story time, guys. Don't forget to give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to comment down below any type of video you'd like to see next. Also, comment down below if you guys want me to expose this YouTube, okay? Because I will do so. And yeah, I love you guys so much. And I'll see you guys in my next video. Mwah. Bye, guys.